usually the sites that are the most suited for wind power development have already been developed. So if you have a site that becomes available again, it's usually a great place. Windplanblauw started about 10 years ago as an initiative together with Vattenfall and SwifterwinT to develop this whole site, which includes 37 onshore turbines and 24 here in the IJsselmeer. The wind farm that stood here before, Irene Vorrink, was 28 turbines along this dike. That capacity can be replaced by 3 of the new turbines, and we have 24.
What I see developing in the offshore market is that clients are getting certain plots and they want to have more output in it. So less turbines, but bigger capacity turbines. This is the biggest challenge which we have in the market of bigger turbines, which means that using a certain capacity crane is not sufficient anymore. So we're already seeing a lot of ring cranes, the PTC and the SKs, now entering the renewables industry.
So if you have the opportunity to tear down the original turbines and replace them with bigger, better, more powerful ones, more economical ones, then it's usually a great place because that's where the wind conditions will be the best.
The cycle of installing a wind turbine for Windplanblauw starts at the Marshalling Harbour in Amsterdam, where seagoing vessels loaded with components are offloaded and components are put in storage. And when time is ready, we get them out of storage. Components are pre-assembled, loaded onto feeder barges, and sailed to the installation site on the IJsselmeer. Thereafter, we get this barge into position next to a foundation. We stabilize the barge by sput legs. And thereafter, we boom up and get the feeder barges loaded with components moored alongside.
What we have done based on a similar project with IJsselmeerwind, that we use the same installation spread with the barge, the stabilization legs and then an 11350 on it. Due to the fact that we have a higher hook height required of 25 meters, the boom length didn't fit on the barge itself. So we had an additional barge installed on top of the installation barge to overcome the length. But also we needed to use a boom rest in connection with the cantilever system to allow us to store the hook block during relocation. And therefore we solved mainly the challenges in the nautical way and all the movements we had in the project.
Due to the size of the installation spread, we mobilized all components to a port at the IJsselmeer. And at the end of the project, we do the same, but then the other way around. Once the crane is boomed down, the hook block is still well in front of the barge. Therefore, we came up with the solution of a hook block tilting frame, where we can store the hook block, boom down the crane, to move to the next foundation.
Behind me right now is the installation spread from Mammoet. So at this moment we're installing a so-called drivetrain and hub. After that the blades will be installed on that turbine. See all of these little islands, those are all the foundations for Windplanblauw that we built since the spring of 2022. Steelwork, sand dredging, sand filling. Then there was a lot of concrete works and rebar works. There's been a huge amount of work done. And then after that, all of the nearshore cables, so all of the marine cables that will eventually export the power from the wind farm, were then installed.
It's Since we are near shore, we have to deal with the environmental conditions such as wind and waves. During the engineering phase, we optimized the operational limits. We monitor weather on a daily basis in contact with all parties.
Usually, the sites that are the most suited for wind power development have already been developed. So if you have the opportunity to tear down the original turbines and replace them with bigger, better, more powerful ones, more economical ones, then it's usually a great place because that's where the wind conditions will be the best.
We have been working hard over the last couple of months. We installed all 23 turbines, and there we are at the last one. Weather conditions have been quite challenging this year in the whole of the Netherlands. To speed up the process, we also have put a night shift on this project to have a double shift. Together with our partners, we worked as a team on board during all stages of the project.
What we have seen in the last 3 to 4 years, that the collar cranes which we have, high capacity, are not suitable anymore for the wind, offshore wind related projects due to the fact of the higher weights we need to handle. Therefore, we have seen last time already 3 ring cranes in offshore wind. We're already looking ahead and seeing, okay, we need additional equipment like an SK to handle even more.
During the day shift today, we did all the preparations to start with the lifting of the last blade, and then we will hand over to the night shift to finalize the last 3 blades and to finish the project.